So I'm here in Harkness Road at Oakville, and a couple of months ago, James and Nadine here reached out to me about a situation that had arisen during the rain event that we had in March, where there was a lot of flooding. But the thing is, this where we are now isn't where it floods, or at least it shouldn't be. We're almost at the top of a hill. This is what happened.
This is a site subject to development. They've taken the houses away. There used to be a natural curve to the ridge line. I can see the way it falls off on the other side. When this had a natural curvature, any runoff would exit on this side of the roadway along this entire fence line. But because they've excavated down to a depth of 300 millimetres, it's created a basin which holds a lot more water. And furthermore, it's concentrated the exit of the water from this site, and if I might say so, without any sedimentation control, through this, which is totally overwhelmed. It runs across the road here, and we can see the residue of the sediment, and it makes a beeline for your property over there.
That's correct.
Okay.
There's a combination of water coming down our driveway and down a set of stairs here into the concrete driveway platform.
And how much of that made its way into the dwelling?
I couldn't quantify that, but enough.
But it did come into the dwelling.
It covered probably about 80% of the inside of the dwelling to a depth of between 1 and 3 or 4 inches.
So, James, you were saying that you've been here for about 5 months, but that you've had extended conversations with the previous inhabitants who were here for how long?
They were here for 21 years. They owned the property for 21 years and they left in about April of 2021.
So what was their lived experience of what we might call high rainfall events on this property? Have they ever seen this happen in the past?
They've said that from any of the rain events in the last 21 years, they've never experienced any level of flooding on the property.
So that would suggest that this is the result of specifically what's happening over there.
Yeah.
Now, could you also tell me what response you got from council?
When we first, so it took a while to get in contact with anybody, but the last contact was with a compliance officer, and the general statement was along the lines of that because the developer had not excavated below a depth of 600 millimetres, that they're essentially within their right to do whatever they want. They hadn't breached any compliance regulation.
So there was this chain of correspondence with council, back and forth. Can you please give us an update? Can you please tell us where the liability was? Is it with the developers? Is it with the contractors? Is it with council for not enforcing conditions of consent? And here we are on the 8th of June, and still they've heard absolutely nothing. James, tell me the story.
Well, as you mentioned, we spoke to the council very early on, roughly around the time of the flood, which was early March. And we had difficulty getting in touch with them to begin with. And right throughout the whole process, we've been in touch with them, but the general consensus is that either the council is too busy or they don't believe that the developer is responsible for allowing pollutants to leave the construction site.
So, you know, James and Nadine here have decided to go public about this, not because they're litigious people, but because they've asked council for intervention. Then they engaged myself and another councillor to try and get an answer from council staff about what's been going on. And then, you know, 2 months later, we're still waiting for any kind of a response. Now, apparently you've had some contact from the developers. Could you tell us about that?
So the developers were pretty difficult to get any action out of. More recently, they've said that they're going to request their insurance company talk to us directly, and then we're to have no more contact with the developer himself.
I saw election and then re-election to try and do something about council's really bad reputation for poor customer service, particularly in the area of planning, compliance and enforcement. And James and Nadine's story really just stands out to me as an example of what's wrong with our council and why it badly needs this kind of reform. So we're going public with this issue, with this plea. Can we please get something done to address why a house that's been here for 20 or 30 years and had never been subject to any kind of flooding before is now suddenly subject to a torrent of water pouring through their lounge room because there's a rainfall event because the developers have knocked the top off the hill like you'd knock the top off an egg. And instead of that rainwater falling off the top evenly in every direction, it creates a spout. And all of that water came down through their lounge room. I'm Nathan Zampronio. Thanks for watching.